Ladies and gentlemen, Tom Rhodes.
Hello, Boulder. Hello, perfect place on the earth.
A friend of mine wrote on his Facebook status update that he was feeling suicidal and thinking about jumping off of a bridge. So I poked him. What an exciting time to be alive, my God. Technology's incredible now. A friend of mine has a new iPhone, and he's showing me on his iPhone, he's got pictures of his girlfriend. He's got close-ups of her cookie and pictures of her blowing him. And I'm like, wow, you can do so many things with those. I've got to get a girlfriend. Ooh. Actually, that's a joke on several levels. I just got an iPhone about 6 months ago. How many people have an iPhone? The iPhone is magic. It's like having your own lightsaber, man. But the iPhone is so sensitive, you can't throw it down. Can't be dramatic with an iPhone. Never gonna talk to you again, you fucking asshole! Not only do I have a girlfriend, I have a wife. I just got married a few months ago, everybody. I never wanted to get married ever, but gay people started to make it look cool. Whatever gay people's doing is gonna be cool 10 years from now, so I wanted to beat the rush. I can't believe that's still a big debate politically we're having in the United States, whether or not there should be gay marriage. And I just want everyone here tonight to know that I am for gay marriage. I'm against gay divorce. You chose that asshole, you're gonna stick with that asshole. All my family are hardcore Christians, and they're all overweight, and they're all trying to lose weight on these low-carb diets where you don't eat bread. That's funny, Christians not eating bread. And Jesus said, take this bread and eat it. It is my body. And the disciples said, Jesus, we're all on low-carb diets. We appreciate you dying for our sins, but we're all trying to slim down a little bit. We want to look good in the painting. So my mother is a super Christian. She often wears a cape. And I got married this year on April 22nd. April 22nd was the 3-year anniversary of my wife and I's first date. Isn't that romantic? Well, it just turns out April 22nd this year was also Good Friday. And my super religious mother flipped out. She's like, you can't get married on Good Friday. That's the day they killed Jesus. I'm like, why do they call it Good Friday? Shouldn't it be called Shitty Ass Bullshit Friday? But it's not like we were choosing a date going September 11th, Hitler's birthday. Oh, let's do it on the day they killed Jesus. I mean, what's the big deal anyway? He gets up a couple days later. It's not like he stayed down. Can't have the happy Easter part without the shitty ass bullshit Friday part. So my wife and I, we're all in love and shit. We're in the running through the park with balloons stage of the relationship. Everything's happy. New love is like a narcotic, man. But you can't do normal things when you're all crazy in love with somebody, like play a board game. You ever try and play Scrabble with someone you're totally in love with? Baby, will this move interfere with anything you're thinking about? It's okay. 5 years later, get your shit off the board. That ain't a word. Thought you went to college. You're a moron. You really thought smoot was a word? My wife is from Holland, and I'm very proud of Dutch people right now because they just announced a building that's gonna replace the World Trade Center in New York City. they chose a Dutch architecture firm. And I don't know if you saw the design in the newspaper, but it's going to be magnificent. It's going to be one of the tallest buildings in the world, and it's going to be a windmill, and then the fans will be able to knock down any incoming aircraft. Too soon? Big controversy in the United States last year. They wanted to build a mosque at Ground Zero. Do you think there should be a mosque at Ground Zero? I think in the United States, we should build a mosque on top of every building. Then we'd never get attacked. Just a little tiny mosque on top of the 7-Eleven. Bully, bully, gully, bully. That's the call to my morning breakfast burrito. It's pretty exciting what's happening in the Middle East with all these revolutions. Libya just fell. I just want to say, I don't think Muammar Gaddafi was that smart. The guy ran his own country for 40 years and he only made himself a colonel. In my country, colonels make fried chicken. Everywhere in the Middle East, man. They show anywhere in the Middle East on the news, people are burning American flags all over the Middle East. There must be a store that only sells American flags. And when you buy it, the guy says, "You want matches with that?" My brother's a career army guy. You want to upset my brother? All you have to do is bring up gays in the military. He goes, "Ape shit. I don't want no fags looking at my dick." Yeah, I bet they're all joining up specifically to look at your dick. I bet it's an incentive down at the recruiting office. They probably have posters everywhere that say, "Join now and see John Rhodes' dick." I don't know how you feel about gays in the military, but I'll tell you one thing. If I'm in a war, watching my buddies die and get blown to pieces all day, I'm gonna need a hug. Just hold me, man. Everyone was so mean. Everybody's so angry with Michael Vick. I just want to say, I think this whole Michael Vick dogfighting story is about stereotypes. And how one group is judged differently than another. I mean, really, if these were cats, nobody would give a fuck. And pit bulls are a vicious animal. They'll grab your throat and rip out your jugular vein. I read that if you are ever attacked by a pit bull, that you should stick your finger in its asshole. My question is, what if that's the reason the dog is biting you in the first place? I did a radio interview a few months ago, and they introduced me as the bad boy of comedy. I never said I was a bad boy of anything, nor do I want to be introduced as such. Only in comedy do you ever hear that. You never hear that in other professions. You never hear, "He's the bad boy of gynecology." See the dude put on his gloves with the fingers cut off? They built a wall at the border between the United States and Mexico. That really angers me, man. These are the people who gave us the margarita. Why would we separate ourselves from such magic people? I don't know if you read in the newspaper, but Mexico was considering legalizing all forms of drugs. If they do that, they'll have to build a wall to keep me out. Mexico, por favor, it's your amigo Tomas, please, Mexico. I can do yard work. I can clean. I'll stand in front of El Casa Depot all day. Only four people took high school Spanish here. That's great. No, no, no. We need to annex Mexico and make it part of the United States, everybody. That's our destiny. We need to annex Mexico. We need to get rid of our flag and adopt Mexico's flag. It's got an eagle standing on a cactus, squeezing the shit out of a rattlesnake. Nobody would ever fuck with us if we carried that flag. Does anybody fuck with Mexico? No, and it's because of that flag. We need to annex Mexico and make it part of the United States. Then we need to send the drug cartels from the north of Mexico to Iraq and Afghanistan and turn them loose. Then those Iraqis and Afghans would be left to wonder. Who are those people with the Virgin Mary tattoos? They were the most ruthless people we had ever met in our life. We should have looked at their flag and known not to fuck with them. You ever been to Mexico? All the men pictured on the money all look pissed off. They all got this look on their face like it's hot and our money isn't worth very much. And they got these big, fat, huge coins that look like they should be filled with chocolate. And if they were, but they maybe they'd be worth a little bit more. Everybody complains about Mexican people coming to our country and taking all the good jobs. And it's a bunch of bullshit. English people are coming here and taking all the good jobs. Pierce Morgan. That little fucking Geico lizard. Every pissy judge on every TV talent show is from England. I thought the song you sang was rubbish. Are you in this country legally, motherfucker? Food is terrible in England. That ain't no joke. The Germans should have dropped cookbooks on those fucking people. Well, the United States, we just got our credit score lowered. If we keep screwing things up, pretty soon we're gonna have to move back in with England. Hey, Dad, I'm back. Things didn't work out too well in the new world. Just let me know where I can hang my Justin Bieber poster. One thing I hate about modern living in the United States now is you pay for anything with a $20 bill or higher, and they pull out their counterfeit magic marker. And they write on your shit, and they hold it up to the light. They sell those counterfeit magic markers at Staples. I always have one on me. They pull that shit on me when they give me my change. I pull out my counterfeit magic marker. That five looks suspicious. I read that last year, because of handguns, there were 6 deaths in Canada. 6! Last year, because of handguns, there were 18 deaths in all of Europe. And in the United States, we had 32,863. Apparently, we don't tolerate as much bullshit here. So go to Canada if you want to run your mouth, bitch. We don't play that shit here. It was really heartbreaking what happened in Arizona earlier this year, and that guy shot that congresswoman and killed all those people. Just goes to show you, guns don't kill people, losers kill people. The kid was a fucking loser. Happens all the time in the United States. Some loser snaps, has to go somewhere and shoot a bunch of people. We got too many losers in this country, man. That's why I think we should encourage suicide. Yes. Life. It's not for everybody. Some people aren't strong enough for it, man. All bridges should be built with diving boards. With a little sign next to it that says a quicker way to a better place. Hey, and if you're having emotional problems, I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about anyone who would do harm to others, okay? Okay. It's funny, whenever I'm in this part of the country, I'm always reminded of suicide. Because I don't understand how anybody could ever kill themselves knowing that a Chick-fil-A sandwich tastes so good. I mean, what problem do you have that you'd never want another Chick-fil-A? Chick-fil-A is only in certain parts of the country, man. Seattle, Washington leads the country in suicides. Ain't got no Chick-fil-A. So, Rick Perry's running for president. I hope he chooses Sarah Palin as his running mate, because Sarah Palin would be the first vice president that I wanted to titty fuck since Al Gore. It's an inconvenient truth. I know the country's divided. Everybody hates each other's guts now. I still have hope. I still love Obama. I love Obama so much. I love Obama so much when I read the newspaper, I spread it out on the table and I put heart-shaped candies around his head. And I eat the little heart-shaped candies while I read the article. I love him. I'm proud to have a black president. Now we can blame black people for all the problems. Oh, I'm so happy that the burden of whiteness has been lifted from my shoulders. I'm proud to have a black president. Now maybe finally McDonald's will continuously leave the McRib on the menu. And this injustice will finally come to an end. Obama's getting a lot of negative news media, man. I think America's afraid. We're afraid once we go black, we'll never go back. White people never say cool shit like that. You never hear, once you go white, you may also enjoy a Sprite. I love Elvis Presley. I think Elvis Presley is the perfect metaphor for the United States. Because Elvis started out young and sexy and innovative, and then he became all fat and disgusting and bloated. And that's where I think the United States is now. We're in our fat Vegas jumpsuit Elvis period. Too fucked up to know that the audience isn't digging us anymore. This crowd loves me, man. I can do whatever I want. Karate kick, baby. I know more about Elvis Presley than I do the Bible. Do you know, at the end of Elvis's life, he used to like to take uppers and downers, pills, and he liked to eat cheeseburgers, and then he would wash it down with a vanilla milkshake, and the drugs and the meat and the sugar was a high that he enjoyed, and he would pass out. And there was a guy that worked for Elvis, and it was his job to go in after he had passed out and dig out the cheeseburger chunks from his mouth so he wouldn't choke to death. When I think about that guy, I think about Barack Obama. Because Barack Obama was the guy that was hired to dig out the cheeseburger chunks from Elvis's mouth. It's not really his fault if the fat fuck dies. Now more than ever, we need Oprah Winfrey. And she abandoned us when we needed her the most. Oprah's retired now. What do you think she should do? I think she should be the Pope. Popra. Way more people love Oprah than love the Pope. Pope never stopped in the middle of a mass and went, everyone look under your seats. You're all getting a Pope-mobile. And you get absolution, and you get absolution, and you all get absolution. I think that women are the highest form of art on the planet. And that they should be worshipped the way that the Egyptians worshipped the sun. I also think that religious fanaticism is what's wrong with human existence right now. And people get it all wrong anyway, man. God is a woman. You know how I know this? My balls. Most important part of a man's anatomy, his balls. It's where the juice that makes the babies is heated up. Our entire existence depends on the man's balls. It's protected by the thinnest layer of skin on my body. If God was a man, your balls would be as hard as your skull, man. You could never hurt them. You could fall off your bike as often as you liked. I think that billboards are spiritual pollution and distract us from nature's divine presence. I don't know if you've been in Las Vegas recently. All over Las Vegas now, there's billboards of some dude, muscular from the waist up. It looks like a Calvin Klein underwear ad. And it says, men, earn $500 quickly now. And what it is, it's a gay website that will pay men $500 if you let them film you jacking off. And my question is, will they accept existing footage? Oh, Boulder, I love you people, man. Don't ever change, Boulder. You people are so adorable with your conspiracy theories. Oh, my God, I love it. It just warms my heart to listen to. So funny, man. You got to be gentle with those people. Pretend like you believe it. It always comes back to the dollar bill, man. You ever look at the back of a dollar bill, man? There's a pyramid, and at the top of the pyramid, there's an eyeball. And that represents the Illuminati and the same six rich people who own everything that we're all corporate slaves to. Wow. And they would have gotten away with it had they not left that huge clue on the back of a dollar bill. Wow. It's like a bad Scooby-Doo episode. Those darn kids ruined everything. We would have ruled the world, but we put a fucking eye on the top of the pyramid. I was at Subway sandwich shop, and the girl behind the counter asked me, do you want to double your meat? I said, who doesn't? A friend of mine just had a baby. It's funny the names of diapers. You got Loves and Huggies, but for adult diapers, they're called Depends. And that's because if a little bitty baby shits in his pants, you still want to love him and hug him. But if an old person shits in his pants, you still love him? Depends. Depends if I'm in the wheel or not. If I'm in the wheel, I'll wipe your ass and powder your balls, old man. Just don't forget little Tommy. Whenever I see a magician do a trick, I like to yell, burn him, he's a witch. I think in the country of Turkey, there should be a city called Gobble Gobble. I don't know why everybody in the country of Hungary doesn't just move to Turkey. I wrote that joke at Thanksgiving. I was sitting at the children's table, and I was killing them 9-year-olds. You too funny, Uncle Tom. My little niece does gymnastics now. My favorite thing about gymnastics is this one move. Why are gymnasts the only ones allowed to do that pimp-ass move, man? We need to steal that shit and incorporate it into our everyday lives. Whatever your job is, when you finish the task, you should plant and nail it. If you're a mailman, you put the letter in the hole. Feels good, people. Don't you think that a PT Cruiser looks like a midget hearse? Every time I see a PT Cruiser, I think a midget has died. I better turn on my lights and follow him. Just so it looks like the little fella had one friend. I hate PT Cruisers, and now I have a reason. I was in Los Angeles last month, and I rented a car, and I got an economy car, and they gave me a PT Cruiser. And I already hate this car. And I'm on Wilshire Boulevard trying to take a left, and in front of me, there's a 1964 lowrider Impala with a very tattooed arm sticking out of the window. And the green arrow light had come on. And I just wanted to give the dude a little boop, boop. We can all go now, friend. But the fucking horn stuck, man. Bang! And this guy from Training Day is getting all agitated and shit. And I'm flipping out and I'm trying to unstick the horn, so I start banging on the wheel. Now I look like this angry asshole lunatic. Bang! Now I walk with a limp. I'm all right. I'm trying to quit smoking cigarettes. It's very difficult. You know, I think there'll come a time when one day we'll see ashtrays in museums. And people will wonder why we ever did that. But you know, there's nothing cooler than blowing smoke out of your face. Look, I'm a little factory. There's work getting done. Can't you see the smoke? I have to admit, I love cigarette smokers. I don't know any cigarette smokers who are prejudiced. Because all cigarette smokers know, we're all black on the inside. There's worse habits than smoking cigarettes. Country hillbilly fuckers do that tobacco shit in their lip. That Skull Copenhagen shit. And I don't know what sensation that gives people. Maybe it helps them hate minorities better. Because it's only really redneck white trash people that do that shit. And they had this guy on the news last year. I don't know if you saw it or not, but he had done that tobacco shit in his lip and he got cancer and they had to remove his jaw. It was gruesome. Dude had no chin. His lip just went straight down to his teeth. And he's on TV being interviewed going, I didn't expect that to happen. I'm looking at this guy and I'm thinking, how does this guy fold pillowcases? So unless you want an unruly linen closet, stay away from that shit. Wow, you guys loved that one, shit. That was really fucked up too, man. All right. I wasn't gonna do this joke, but since you like the dude with no chin so much. I really love barbecue pork. And I was in Louisiana a few months ago, and somebody had told me about this barbecue restaurant that was like famous, and I went in there, and I'd never eaten in this restaurant before. And when I walked in there, there was a dude in there eating, and he had a tumor the size of a fist growing on the side of his head. It's all bumpy and gory and weird and shit. It was obviously something that somebody should have had looked at a lot sooner. But I saw this guy, and I got happy, because I figured, you know it's some good barbecue if it brought this motherfucker out of the house. I'm from the state of Florida. Maybe you've seen it on a map. It's the only state shaped like a dick. Especially the way the Keys squirt off onto Cuba. It's the only state with its own money shot. I'm from Orlando, Florida, and it had been about 15 years since I had been to Disney World. And a few days after Christmas, I took my wife and my mother to Disney World. My favorite thing about Disney World is that the little kids wear the Mickey Mouse ears all day. And they actually sell those in adult sizes. And I thought, I want to be a little kid all day. So I got the Mickey Mouse ears, and my wife got the Minnie Mouse ears. And we had a really nice day at Disney World. Then later in the afternoon, we're eating at one of these Disney restaurants, and my wife had this misunderstanding with this Brazilian woman at the next table. They're sitting on like a bench, and you know the plastic trays at McDonald's you carry the food on? There was like a stack of them. And this Brazilian woman got pissed off about something, and she slapped the trays. and they slammed him against my wife's thigh. My wife went, bitch. And the Brazilian woman jumped up. And her muscular Brazilian husband jumped up. And that's animal instinct shit, man. You gotta protect your woman. So I fucking jumped up. And the Brazilian dude stepped in on me. And I can't believe this guy's ready to fight at the happiest place on earth. And I bowed up and I'm ready to throw down. And I realize I got these dumbass Mickey Mouse ears on. And Mickey Mouse came running over and held the Brazilian guy back. Goofy came running over and was holding me back. I said, fuck him, Mickey. He didn't buy the hat. He don't love you like I love you, Mickey. Get off me, Goofy, goddammit. Hey, everybody. Next time you're on Facebook, if you could do me a favor and like the Tom Rhodes fan page. Just like it. Tom Rhodes, R-H-O-D-E-S, like the Rhodes Scholar, Tom Rhodes fan page. Just like it. I'm actually from a little town outside of Orlando called Oviedo. And it's a little citrus farming town. And we've got these wild chickens that walk around on the downtown area. It's what my little town is known for. And it just shows you how country it is there. And they're called the Oviedo Chickens. The Oviedo Chickens have a fan page on Facebook, and 9,200 people like it. I have a fan page on Facebook, and 820 people like it. If you guys could just help me beat those fucking chickens. And when you push the button, you can go, fuck you, chickens. My very religious mother is on Facebook now. So whenever I put a status update, I'll put things like, reading scriptures tonight. The book of Matthew is blowing me away. Jesus is real. And then my mom will like it. Don't be a dick. That was Jesus' whole message. Don't be a dick. That's what it all comes down to. I was in Austin, Texas a few years ago, driving around on a Saturday afternoon, and there was a protest in front of a Honda automobile dealership. 30 or 40 people were marching angrily with placards and signs, and their signs said things like, gay is not okay, and the word of God condemns homosexual acts. And it was a curious sight, and I stopped. And there was a guy, he looked like Moses. I figured he was in charge. I go, hey, man, what's happening? I swear to God, the guy goes, well, it seems some people who claim to be Christians have hired some homosexuals to sell Hondas. And the Lord don't want homosexuals selling Hondas. Does it say that in the Bible? I admit, I skipped around a lot. It could be in there. I thought the whole point of the book was love your neighbor. It doesn't say go to his work and fucking bother him. If those people truly would have been following the Bible, their signs would have said, my gay neighbor drives a Honda and I love him. My Peter Licking Honda driving neighbor gets 44 miles to the gallon on the highway. And when he doesn't have a ball sack draped across his nose, he's getting 33 in the city. Love your neighbor, everybody. That's the point of that joke. I think that hell was a concept created to get dumb people to act right. At least that's what I'm counting on. It's a sad and disgusting fact, but within Europe, the country of Belgium is known for pedophilia. And they've had a real problem with it in the last 10 to 20 years. You ever think maybe that's the reason why the Belgians make such good chocolate? Because little kids are smart. They won't get into the van for any shitty old chocolate. It's got to be the very best. I was in Geneva, Switzerland last year, and I did that joke. And after the show, this Swiss woman comes up to me, and she goes, "Your joke about the Belgian child molester. I was wondering why you did not use the Swiss chocolate." I think everyone in the audience was wondering, why is he not using the Swiss chocolate? And I just think it's hilarious that the woman was concerned that the child molester in my joke was not using the best chocolate available. I said, "Lady, let's be honest. If the guy would have had a Toblerone, I would have fucked him. If he would have had a jumbo Toblerone, I'd have put on the Boy Scout suit with the butt cut out. Okay, lady? Because that is some good chocolate." Hey, look at my bald spot, everybody. Actually, that is not a bald spot. That is an old breakdancing injury. I was in Alaska, however long ago you need for this joke to be relevant. And there was a very interesting story on the news the week I was in Alaska. Four homeless people had been eaten and killed by bears. And that's what I like the most about Alaska, is if you're homeless, you're part of the food chain. Come on, Boulder, wouldn't that be great? If once a year, bears came into the city and ate all the homeless people. Well, I forgot, you guys have bears here, shit. Maybe they do, I don't know. I should have researched that joke a couple days ago, I guess. Before the show, Tommy, won't you check on a joke reference? In the future, every job in Alaska will become a television program. Ice Road Dairy Queen worker. World's most deadliest Subway sandwich shop artist. Survivor mailman. Do you guys know what Jelly Belly jelly beans are? The world's greatest jelly bean! The tangerine tastes like tangerine and the pear tastes like pear. These people are magic. I ate Alaskan king crab every day that I was in Alaska. Alaskan king crab is my second favorite taste on the planet. Alaskan king crab dipped in hot melted butter. Versus flesh rose petals glistening with saliva. Why don't the Jelly Belly Jelly Bean people ever come out with either of those flavors? Blueberry, buttered popcorn, pussy. I knew it! I could feel it in my heart. I watched you people come in here tonight, and I looked at your beautiful faces, and I could feel in my heart that this was gonna be a pussy-flavored jelly bean crowd. I knew it. I knew it in my heart. You would be surprised how many anti-pussy flavored jelly bean crowds there are. But that's the kind of shockingly good idea that made this country strong, people. Let's never forget that. Ideas do not become reality until you voice it out loud, man. One day you're gonna be at home watching a movie, eating a bowl of jelly beans. Not all that guy's ideas were good, but the pussy flavored jelly beans, you know. You know, our country's come a long way, and I'm really proud of it, man, and gay rights and gay parades and shit. But how come when a heterosexual guy talks about his shit, everybody gets a little freaked out, man? Where's my day? Where's the I love licking pussy day? Where's my parade? See a big old paper mache tongue coming down the street. See veterans lined up along the boulevard. God bless you, son. Look at him right there. Fine young American pussy licker. Look at him. You keep this country strong there, Junior. I I recently spent a few months traveling around Asia, and the knowledge nugget I have brought back for you from Asia is that the most beautiful women in the world are Thai men. All right, you've been there. I was in Japan, and I performed for the United States Marine Corps, ladies and gentlemen. It's a real honor to perform for the troops, but let's be honest, doing comedy for the Marines can be kind of a difficult gig, man. I did 5 nights at 5 different Marine bases in Okinawa, and every night, somebody fucked my mom. Because that's where their level of humor was at. Hey, I fucked your mom! Thanks, hero. That's interesting. You fucked my mom. Wow. You may have noticed that I'm a little overweight. And that's because every time I fuck your mom, she gives me a cookie. Sometimes you go, yeah, well, I fucked your mom better. I forgot to mention that your mom's pussy is so dry that the crabs carry canteens. It's important that we always remember to honor our returning war veterans. My father fought in Vietnam, and he was wounded physically, not mentally, and that's a good thing. Some people are screwed up from their experiences in combat, man. I had a Little League baseball coach, and he was a Vietnam veteran. He was all fucked up from his experience in the war, man. He'd always tell our team crazy shit. Same man would make an error out in the field. It's the same man who would get his whole platoon blown up in Vietnam. I dropped a pop fly and killed all my buddies. Can I still have a soda? I'm trying to remove all pornography from my life, ladies and gentlemen. Guy's sitting with beautiful women and you're booing that, really? I think it's hilarious that you guys are on dates and then you fucking booed that. That's so funny. Boo! I'm gonna drop her off and then I'm gonna go beat off. Boo! I don't wanna fuck the real thing. I just wanna, you know, squirt it on my chest and get back to Sports Center. Why don't you leave your dick alone and develop a relationship? Oh, God. That's hilarious, man. I don't know if you guys have ever seen a comedy show before, but sometimes the beginning of the joke isn't what the intent of it's going to be. So, you know, sometimes if a subject is presented, you might want to just fucking wait a minute. Let's see where the fuck we're going. I'm trying to remove all pornography from my life. Pornography is a human rights issue. Because it is the exploitation of male loneliness. And it's gotta stop. I'm tired of being exploited. There's always too many dicks involved in porno. Why's it gotta be 16 dicks and one woman, man? Why's it always gotta end in a fountain of sperm, you know? Why can't it be one man and one woman? Why can't he come inside her and there be some cuddling? The last 5 minutes of every porno movie should be the man sleeping. A friend of mine recently moved to Van Nuys, California, which is only significant in that it is the porno-making capital of the world. I told my friend he needed to buy a trampoline. Wouldn't that be funny? You're watching a porno movie and then all of a sudden in the background you just see some guy fucking... I lived in Holland, and I was lucky enough to do a travel program, and I got to do a highlight on Peru. And in Peru, they eat guinea pigs. It's a delicacy. And because we were filming it, I had to try it, and I didn't like it. Thank God. Wouldn't that suck if you found out you loved guinea pigs? You'd have to hang out at pet stores all the time. They keep dying. Maybe the wheel is too tight. I think llamas would be the perfect pet because they have these little perfectly round golf ball-sized turds that would be very easy to clean up. Or you could get a 5-iron and your neighbor could clean it up. I feel the same way about golf as I do cocaine. I would like to do it a lot more often. There's just not that many people I want to spend that much time with. Oh, good, some golfers. My favorite golfer's in the toilet. Tiger Woods, man. He used to be so confident, badass, panther, prowl. Now he's all slump shoulder and shit. Everybody knows I fucked up. He came out at that press conference and he apologized. His wife left him anyway. He never should have apologized at that press conference. He should have come out of that press conference and went, yeah, I fucked all them bitches. I'm Tiger Woods, squirt, squirt. I'm the greatest golfer that ever, Jack Nicklaus didn't get half the pussy I got. I'm Tiger Woods, squirt, squirt. When he came back, spectators should have worn protective eye gear to protect their retinas from any ricocheting sperm that may have happened on the golf course. I was in Paris. People are smart in Paris. I mean, even the children speak French. I love Paris because Paris is very much about honoring women. All over Paris are statues of women, and all their artwork is always women. And it's usually centered around themes of the French Revolution. And if you're familiar with French art of that period, the women usually have a titty hanging out. There's a famous Delacroix painting. I know you've seen it. It's the national symbol of France. This woman is carrying a French flag, and there's a dirty-faced pistol boy next to her, and she has a titty hanging out. It's almost like French artists of that period had a conversation amongst themselves. It's feasible. Titty would have popped out. It was a revolution. There was lots of activity. Straps were not that strong. I bet titties must have popped out all the time. I took French in high school, and I got a D, and that always pissed me off because I really worked my ass off in that class. Mrs. Lee, bitch, whore! You guys should really do comedy. It's very therapeutic. So the first love of my adult life was with a French girl from Paris, Natalie. And we lived together in San Francisco for 7 years. And the very first time I ever went to Paris, Natalie got sick one night, and I went up by myself, and I got mugged by these two guys. They're walking towards me on this thin Parisian street, and one of them had this metal walking brace. And when they got closer to me, the dude jammed me in the stomach with it. And it's go time, baby. It's 2-1. And I'm not proud of it. I don't know where it came from. I barked at them. Ruff! And that made the dude with the pole start wailing on me, man. But it was winter and I had a big coat on, so it actually didn't hurt too bad. And then I looked to see what dude number two was doing, and dude number two maced me right in the eyeballs. And I've never felt such excruciating pain in my life. You have no idea how many nerve endings are in your eyes. And I freaked out, and I wailed my arms, and I broke free, and I'm running, and I'm blinded, and all this pain. And it's amazing, the shit that's stuck in the cracks of your head. I don't know where it came from. I just looked back, and I went, Ajante! Which means, nice to meet you. I can't believe I got a D in that fucking class, man. I got to apply my shit on the streets of Paris. I bet there were kids who got A's who never got to apply their shit on the streets of Paris. Mrs. Lee, bitch whore. Every man has to face the day that his sports career ends. And for me, that was in 11th grade. I played junior varsity football in 9th and 10th grade. When I was in 11th grade, I was 17, and I started doing stand-up comedy. And I was hanging out in nightclubs every night, and I was getting drunk with comedians, and that's how you learn to do comedy. And if you want to go out for football, you got to go out for football a month before school starts. And that's August in Florida, the hottest month of the year. And I was at this practice, and I think the message of this story is you have to be grateful for the people who saved you time in your life, because so many people waste your time. And for me, man, my high school football coach saved me like 10 years of wasted effort. I was at this practice, and I'm hungover, and I'm just totally, I was worthless, just dragging dick. And in front of the whole team, the coach goes, Rhodes, you're going to have to ask yourself, do you want to stay out all night and chase pussy, or do you want to play football? I never went back another day in my life. It was like the guy had turned a light on for me, you know? Do I smoke weed? I do, sir. Marijuana is not a drug. It is a plant that is growing in my closet. I'll tell you the worst thing that ever happened to me from smoking marijuana. Years ago, I was performing in Appleton, Wisconsin. And I met these two women after the show, and they were nurses, and they worked together. And they bought me a drink after the show and were talking, and they were telling me through the course of the evening that they were really good friends and that they had always wanted to have sex with a guy together. So they chose this dude that they worked with at the hospital, and they fucked him. And he told everybody. And everyone in their little town where they lived knew. Everyone in the hospital where they worked knew. And then it dawns on me why they're telling me this story. I'm from out of town. I'm not going to tell anybody but strangers and comedy audiences for the rest of my life. So we go back to my hotel room, and it's on, baby. And I had never been with two women before. I didn't know what threesome etiquette was. When we get back to my room, I pull out a joint, and I went, you guys want to smoke some pot? And I swear to God, they looked at each other and went, oh my God, there's drugs? We gotta go. And they left. And that was the loneliest joint I've ever smoked in my life. Why didn't I wait until afterwards to offer it? Well, stay cheerful, everybody. There's enough bitter turds on this planet. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have been offended by anything I have said tonight, I'm sure this next joke will be your favorite. Ladies, every man has a secret. And regardless of what your man tells you after this show, the truth of the matter is, at one point in every man's life in this room, he has tried to suck his own dick. Look at the looks of recognition. At one point in every man's life in this room, he has gotten up onto his back shoulder blades, flipped his legs over, and let it dangle to see if he was that one lucky member of Cirque du Soleil. I tried that when I was a teenager, and I got stuck like that, man. Oh, and it was so fucked up because my dad walked in on me. He went, ew. And he said, it doesn't work, does it? All right, Boulder, you guys are the best. Thank you so much.